What's up, yo guys? Welcome back to my channel. So today, as from the title you can see, I'm going to review that Nika K palette and this eyeshadows. As you can see, the pretty eye look, it's looking very nasty from far, but it's like very nice as you can see. So this is how my eye look turned out. So if you want to try this eye look, please keep on watching. And as you can see, I have done a lot of swatches and a lot of stuff. So before I dive into the video, please subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell, so every time I upload a new video you get notified. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So today I'm going to talk about this three eyeshadow palettes which I have bought from Hawk Makeup. If you want to know the deals about Hawk Makeup and the combos, I have bought these three combos and it costed me ₹1,000. Usually they one of a pan cost ₹499 or ₹399, something sort of. I will link everything in the description, and if you want to check the Hawk Makeup video, I will link everything in this eye over here somewhere. So this three, so first I'm going to talk about this Sugar Plum palette. These have 6 glitters and 3 mattes. As you can see, I've already digged in very much. I have completed this eye look. I'm going to swatch this one. So now I'm going to do this poison apple one. So for the starters, I'm going to use this yellow color and lay it in a rounder shape on my outer crease. This is my transition color. This is the shape I'm going for, this round shape. So first you have to lay the color. As you can see, at this, first of all, this colors are not that pigmented. This yellow actually is not that pigmented. It is buildable, which I like kabow. If you put a color in kabow, it's like too powerful. It's very hard for the users, like for the starter users. So it's good sometimes to build color up, and sometimes if you are in a rush and you know this pigment is slow builder, it's an issue. Like, it depends from person to person, varies from time to time. So my yellow is all blend, as you can see. For now, I'm going to use another color from this palette. I'm going to taste all the palette and see how everything works. So I'm using multicolor option over here. As you can see, there are a lot of colors from 3 of the palettes. And so now I'm going to use, why I'm doing this, why I'm talking like this. So I'm going to use this orangey color. This is the red one, this is the orange one. I'm going to use this orange color on this kind of a brush with an angle in it. I'm going to put that on the upper part and take the color position wand and blend that yellow. Now I'm going to use this Sugar Plum palette from Nika K, this palette, and I'm going to lay this color over here. And for to deepen it up, I'm going to use this berry plum color. So after blending that purple color, I'm going to deepen that up with this deep purpley something color. I'm going to deepen that up and give it more a purpley theme. This seems more pinky right now. I'm going to use this blue shimmer. So there are different kinds of shimmers in everything. These are shimmer. As you can see, they are a bit chunky some place and some they are not. These are very fine shimmers, but these are very hard pressed. This lacks the pigment if you press them really hard, and it's really hard to get. So if you can see, I'm using this, and if I swipe over here, there's not lot coming out. That's what I'm talking about. So you have to really press yourself, and sometimes it's nice. There's a lot less, and there is something, as you can see, I have done this side, there is no fallout. And as you can see for yourself also, there is no fallout. They are not paying me or something. But so now I'm going to use a blue liner, any blue liner you have, and I'm going to line my underline. So after blending that a bit, I'm going to use this pink, this hot pink color. This both seems same, but this are not. This is a bit lighter and this is a deeper. I'm going to use the deeper one, and I'm going to use that on the front of my lash line. So sorry for the interruption. This is another eye look I have done with Poison Apple palette, and now let's get back to the video again.
So as you can see, my both eye is almost all complete. My face is all complete, and this is how I'm looking. I know the sun is going down and the screen, my camera is not working properly. My camera is not of a nice quality, but as you can see, the both eye turned out really good. So my final verdict on this one
It's like, as you can see, I am loving this red, this berry color, this red red and this orange. I'm loving it. They're working really great actually. So from the swatches, as you can see, like, I hope it's visible, it's a one-time swatch. Like, it's pigmented, but as you drag, it loses pigments. But I'm not like judging on the swatches. I have used them on my eyes, and as you can see, I'm loving this shimmers over here. This poison apple, these shimmers are really good, and this bone color is like for everybody. Like, for everybody, you can use it on your crease, you can use it to set your base. And so that goes for this one. And next, I'm going to talk about this butter palette. This palette is like really, you have to build the intensity of this color. Like, that's yellow. I have dragged that yellow till down to my cheeks, and it is almost gone. Like, I have powder once, and usually the pigments of this eyeshadows don't go really quick. Those yellow is like very dimmed. I'm loving this pink and this pink and this red and orange. Red and orange are like easy colors. Like, both of the palettes are having a nice yellow, red and orange. But I'm not going to be using this shimmer, this one and this one. These are not like workable. I'm not a big fan of this glitter permanently. This blue one, they don't have any name actually. So next, I'm going to talk about this Sugar Plum palette. This palette, so the shimmers, like the glitters over here, are a bit chunky. Okay, these are different from your usual palette. They are workable, they are nice. The purples are really hard to make. Purple from this palette is, I'm liking the mattes. Most of the mattes from three of this palette, I'm liking them actually. The mattes are very workable, but the shimmers are creating a lot of problems. Like, as you can see, there is a lot of kickback. It's a bit powdery, it's a bit chalky. Like, when you dab your this thing, I'm showing you, wait. Take a brush like this and take this thing. Take any color. It's not only because of this. And if you see, it's not visible in the camera. It's not visible in the camera, but it's very dusty. So, and the glitters are like really chunky, except this shimmers. The shimmers are like good, but this glitters are like, they're not glitter actually. For glitter, you have to use adhesive and all that stuff, but it's not glitter. But at this age of 2021, the period of COVID, new makeups are still launching, and they're like a lot better options. I love those, they are not bad actually, but still they're like better options for this alternatives of this one. So overall, I'm giving a yay to this palette, and they are affordable, they are approachable, you can build the color ups, they are like a good quality, but the shimmers, most of them are not workable with. So thank you guys for watching. See you guys later. But before this, please 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 subscribe for more reviews on such stuff. As you can see, the eye look turned out really good. So thank you guys, see you guys later, bye.